Good evening, everyone. I'd like to welcome all of you this evening to tonight's council meeting. We are certainly honored by the presence of all of our veterans here this evening. On behalf of council and myself, I'd like to welcome you to City Hall for our meeting. And before we begin, Mayor Phillips wanted me to extend his regrets for not being able to be here tonight. You know, this is a meeting that he always looks forward to, a time to say thank you to all our veterans and all that you do for our community and what you do to service others in our community. So again, he is a proud grandfather of twins tonight, so I think he had a little bit more important evening tonight to spend with his new grandchildren. So again, he sends his regrets. I'd like to ask Councilman Bittner to please lead us in the invocation, and John Carter, city attorney. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. Pledge of Allegiance and John Carter in our invocation.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, as always, we pause to give you thanks. To give you thanks for the blessings and the benefits that you so graciously bestow upon us individually and collectively as the city of Jacksonville. Tonight we give thanks especially for those veterans who be recognized, but also for all veterans, for their service to our community and their continued work to make us a caring community here in Jacksonville. We want to reach out and to pray for those injured veterans who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. We pray that your healing power would be with them to comfort them. We pray for our service members who are serving us this evening in harm's way, some of them, for their safety, for their anxious families. And as always, we remember our council and our mayor, and we pray that your guidance and direction would always be with them. This we ask in your holy name. Amen. Amen.
All right, thank you. What was I thinking, asking you to do
the invocation? Wow. I was ready.
I know you were. You looked like.
I followed John's lead for years.
Yeah. Again, thank you. The city is very proud of our bond that we have with our local veterans here in our community, the organizations that surround us, and with the Onslow County Council of Veterans. Each year since 1988, the city has asked each veteran group to nominate a veteran from their organization who has demonstrated outstanding volunteerism. Not only volunteerism, but support and leadership during the past year for recognition as our outstanding veteran of the year. At this time, the city would like to show our respect and gratitude to our local veterans by presenting the annual Veterans Awards along with an outstanding citizen's lapel pin. So I will ask council to please join me forward, and I will ask Dr. Woodruff if he will announce the names as we move forward.
As council comes down to take their place, we would encourage those of you who would like to take pictures to feel free to come down. Stand generally on this side of the aisle. Also, anyone who may have difficulty walking, feel free to have an assistant to come. As your name is called, please come forward, receive the congratulations and a picture with Mr. Lazara, a pin from Mr. Willingham, and then the congratulations of the City Council members. We will now begin. AMVETS Post 225, Joseph Trauma, please come forward and be recognized. Mr. Trauma has been a member of the AMVETS Post 225 for the past 15 years. He served also on other veterans organizations. He has devoted many, many hours to local charities, area veterans, and active duty military members. Mr. Trauma, please come forward. Associates of Vietnam Veterans of America, Chapter 654, Donna Marie Crowell. Ms. Crowell has been a member for more than 20 years, is currently the liaison for the chapter. She has served as the North Carolina State Council representative and the Region 3 director. The welfare of veterans is her top priority, and she has served with steadfast dedication. Mrs. Crowell. Beirut Memorial, Chapter 642, Military Order of the Purple Heart, Stan Walker. Mr. Walker has been a member for 5 years and is currently serving as the junior vice commander of the chapter, as well as the chairman of the scholarship committee. The scholarship program was established in 2014. Since that time, 6 scholarships have been awarded. Stan is very involved in the community as he participates in numerous other veterans organizations as well. Thank you, Mr. Walker. Disabled American Veterans, Onslow County, Chapter 16, Grethel Humphrey. Mr. Humphrey has been a valuable member of the chapter for the past 15 years. He is a U.S. Air Force veteran and a veteran of the Vietnam War. He has been the chaplain, the transportation coordinator, and the service order, and the service officer. As a transportation network driver, he has driven veterans to medical appointments throughout the state of North Carolina. Thank you, Mr. Humphrey. Fleet Reserve Association, Branch 208, Mark F. Rogers. Shipmate Rogers, and I think that's an indication that he must have been in the Navy. Yes, sir. No, sir. Shipmate Rogers is an extremely dedicated shipmate who serves as the branch's secretary and treasurer. He maintains the branch's website and makes sure all tasks are handled in a timely manner while holding the branch together. Thank you, Mr. Rogers. Mr. Rogers, I'm just reading what they told me to read. Okay. Fleet Reserve Association, Branch 208, Auxiliary. Annette Cherry, Ms. Cherry. She has been a member for 42 years, is currently serving as the branch's chaplain. She assists in performing funeral ceremonies and providing food for the families. She also delivers goodies to local nursing home facilities, is an advisor to the junior Catholic daughters aged 6 through 18, and assists with publicity for the Church Women United. Ms. Cherry. Loyal Escorts of the Green Garter, Nancy Lizema. My understanding is she is not with us this evening. Is someone here to receive this on her behalf? Okay, let me read it though. Ms. Lizema canvassed area businesses and collected items to be sent to service members who were serving abroad in harm's way. She assisted in organizing the Smiles Project, which sends cards and letters to women who are overseas in field engagement teams. She has been enthusiastic with her support of area veterans by serving in many events. Ms. Lizema. Marine Corps League, Onslow County Detachment 262, Jeffrey Andre. Mr. Andre joined the league in 2014. He has held 3 positions, adjutant, paymaster, chaplain, and assistant chaplain. He visits the sick and homebound veterans and has helped increase the overall membership. He epitomizes the meaning of hard work that every Marine Corps leaguer aspires to have. Mr. Andre. Marine Corps League Auxiliary, Onslow County Detachment 262, Marianne Rooney. Ms. Rooney has long served on many different veterans groups and served as an officer in most. When the Marine Corps League Unit 262 was started, she was the first one to sign up. She was also the first to volunteer to hold office. She currently serves as a historian and keeps a very up-to-date and active scrapbook. Ms. Rooney. Marine Corps League, Swansboro Detachment 1407, Alexander Gunner Negrovsky. Mr. Negrovsky was directly responsible for the establishment of the Swansboro Detachment and the charter for that detachment. He served as the first commandant, has worn many hats within the organization. He has been described as the driving force behind many fundraisers which have benefited Marines, chaplains, corpsmen, and their family. Mr. Navgrosky. How'd I do on that name?
Great, sir.
Good,
great.
Sir. Thank you. Military Retiree Council, Milton Nieves. Mr. Nieves' selfless contributions and professionalism as chairman of the council for the past 3 years is admirable. His actions are consistent with presenting a positive image of the Marine Corps and Naval Service. He epitomizes the unique qualities found in the men and women of the United States Marine Corps. Mr. Nieves. Monford Point Marine Association Chapter 10, Johnny Oliphant. Mr. Oliphant works diligently in the community to coordinate activities and events that create camaraderie, goodwill, esprit de corps. He is involved in all chapter fundraising and is the go-to guy when it comes to planning events. He is a member of the building committee and is always willing to share his talents in carpentry and painting with those in need. Mr. Oliphant. Monford Point Marine Association Auxiliary Chapter 10, Pamela Gaines. Ms. Gaines' resilience has greatly influenced other volunteers to step outside the traditional environment and be comfortable with new ideas for the chapter. Although she has a full-time job, Ms. Gaines devotes numerous hours to the chapter, and her can-do spirit has influenced the other members and has moved this chapter forward. Mrs. Gaines. NavVets Marine Chapter 0054, Wesley Ferguson. Not sure Mr. Ferguson was able to be with us. Let me read this. Mr. Ferguson served in the United States Marine Corps for 26 years, retired as a Master Sergeant. He serves as the Chapter Recording Secretary, Hospitality Coordinator, and does anything necessary to assist the chapter and his community. Mr. Ferguson. NavVets Military Women's Chapter 0088, Cora M. Davis. As the founder and commander of the chapter, Ms. Davis demonstrates her ability to be a leader, a team player, a mentor, and a problem solver. Her commitment and overall awareness of organizational matters allows her to act in these many capacities. Her willingness to help others plays a vital role in improving the quality of life for all veterans in our community. Mrs. Davis. NavVets Veterans United for Community Service, Chapter 0069, Romy Parker, He's not with us this evening, but his sister Sadie Crawley will receive this award. Ms. Crawley. Mr. Parker is the junior vice commander, and he possesses a deep compassion to assist disabled veterans and their families. Upon completion of his current training course, he will be able to be a volunteer veterans service officer. This will enable him to assist veterans and their families in completing their claims, as well as filling out paperwork on various veterans matters and widows obtaining benefits. He has been instrumental in providing services to many homeless veterans. Mr. Parker. Non-Commissioned Officers Association, Downey's Chapter 906, Paul Meeker. Mr. Meeker has been a member of the Downey's Chapter since 2007. He has served as trustee and is currently the chapter chairman. He was instrumental in organizing fundraisers, has donated over 500 hours of personal time just this past year. He continues to display the ideas and principles of someone who deeply cares about his community. Mr. Meeker. NC Works Career Center, Davis Williams. Mr. Williams is the assistant manager of the NC Works Career Center. He has done this for 25 years of service with the state of North Carolina, as well as 20 years of service in the United States Navy. He reaches out to training institutions and human service agencies to increase their awareness and capacity to serve veterans who are seeking employment and training opportunities. Mr. Williams truly believes in helping others. Mr. Williams. ROC 4 Vets, Jeremy Blanks. Mr. Blanks is president of the ROC 4 Vets. As a financial planner, he advises young service members and assists them with their VA claims. He has given over 600 hours of volunteer time with this organization. He is a staunch advocate for veterans and the struggles they encounter, especially when they return home from war. Mr. Blanks. Rolling Thunder Incorporated, Chapter NC-5, Susan Teachout. Ms. Teachout has been a member since 2009, has actively participated in many events, including local bike rides, and those are not the ones you pedal, folks, parades, and merchandising for the chapter. She presently serves as the chapter treasurer and has 33 years of service in the United States Air Force Reserves. Ms. Teachout. The American Legion, Burton Cowell Post 265, Richard J. Mack McGee. Mr. McGee served in the United States Navy, Mr. McGee served in the United States Marine Corps for 26 years, retired in 1980 as the rank of Master Sergeant. He has 13 years of service. Let's do that again. You want to go back and sit and we'll start completely over, okay? Okay, let's do that one more time. Yes, sir, that's where I'm headed, sir. And my apologies, sir. Yes, sir, thank you.
We do our best.
That's it. Mr. McGee served in the United States Marine Corps for 26 years. He retired in 1980 at the rank of Sergeant Major. He has 13 years of service with the American Legion Post, has been instrumental in helping with numerous celebrations and community events. Let's once again welcome Sergeant Major McGee.
Yeah.
The Captain John C. Carr Veterans Resource Center, Samuel Gumpton. Mr. Gumpton devotes his time to students at more than 12 area high schools within several counties, including Onslow. He has often made donations out of his own pocket to help local veterans and their families when they are in need. His dedication to veterans and their families is honorable and outstanding. Mr. Gumpton. Veterans of Foreign Wars, Jacksonville, Post 9133, Thomas P. Duyer. Mr. Duyer, did I get your name fairly correct?
Yes, sir.
Good, thank you. Mr. Duyer served in the United States Marine Corps for 24 years, has been a valuable member of the VFW for many years. His military experience has enabled him to serve the VFW Post 9133 in many capacities, and his willingness to help his fellow veterans and his community knows no bounds. Mr. Duyer. Veterans of Foreign Wars, Jacksonville, Post 9133, Ladies Auxiliary, Faye Webb. Ms. Webb has been a line officer for the past 2 years. Her willingness to take action and achieve results has made her an inspiration to all. Her contributions were rewarded recently by being inducted into the MOC Auxiliary with the honor degree just this past year. She upholds the highest traditions of the Veterans of Foreign War, Ms. Webb. Thank you. Veterans of Foreign Wars, Jacksonville, Post 9133, Military Order of the Kuti Auxiliary, Sarah Lucas. Ms. Lucas has been an outstanding volunteer and president of the post. She has boundless energy, a take-charge attitude, and is an inspiration to all who serve with her. Her dedication to the mission has helped her to uphold the highest traditions of the Veterans of Foreign War. Ms. Lucas. Veterans of Foreign Wars, New Topsail Island, Post 9983, Walt Zabicki. Will you come up? Yes. Mr. Zabicki served in the United States Marine Corps, retiring at the rank of Lieutenant Colonel. He joined the VFW in 1994, has served in many capacities from junior vice commander to post commander. He is currently the chairman of the Voice of Democracy and Patriots Path, which are youth outreach programs of the VFW. He is a positive influence in our community. Mr. Zabicki. Vietnam Veterans of America, John Panarisi, Chapter 654. This is going to be awarded posthumously. Curtis Johnson is going to be receiving the award. Isaac Best, Jr. Sergeant Best, United States Marine Corps retired, was a charter member of the chapter and a very active member until his passing in August of 2016. He served in the Marine Corps for 20 years. He completed 2 tours of duty in Vietnam. He participated in all functions until his health would not allow. He carried the chapter banner until he could no longer walk. And after that, when the chapter received a parade trailer, he would ride proudly in the parade. He became a resident of Carolina River Nursing and Rehabilitation Center, and while there was active, he visited the other veterans in the facility daily. He raised and lowered the colors. He passed out the nursing home newsletter. Throughout his life, he represented the best of the Corps. Mr. Best. Women Marines Association, Tar Heel Chapter NC1, June Mills. As a retired United States Marine, Ms. Mills goes above and beyond to serve active duty and veteran service members. She has been a lifetime member of the association. Ms. Mills has also served in the Military Widow Organization since 1980. She works tirelessly, has given hundreds of volunteer hours to coordinate, recruit, and train the active duty color guard and also cake escorts. Ms. Mills. City of Jacksonville Veterans Liaison. Receiving this award tonight will be Paul Meeker. Paul, if you'll come forward. He is receiving it for Mr. Lewis Allers, who is the city's appointed veterans liaison. As the city's veteran liaison, Mr. Allers is responsible for ensuring that the city of Jacksonville is aware of what is happening in the veteran community and also keeping the veterans groups apprised of various activities and work of the city. The city of Jacksonville appreciates his steadfast support, his tireless efforts in working with the city to support veterans throughout our community. Mr. Allers.
Richard Vincent, thank you very much. We appreciate it. If I can just ask, we have another presentation. If I can ask the council members to please stand up here for a moment. And I would like to ask William Joseph, the director of the Randy Reichler Reception Center, Board Campus, you to come forward. This year, the city is honored to present a proclamation reaffirming the city's support for our veteran community and their families. I would like to ask all of our veterans in attendance tonight if they could just please stand for a moment while I read the proclamation. Whereas, the city of Jacksonville and Onslow County are the home of Camp Lejeune and New River Air Station, and whereas these Marines and sailors constitute America's 911 response team for protecting our freedoms and way of life, and whereas a major portion of the population of the city of Jacksonville is comprised of active duty military, their family members, and veterans, and whereas each year approximately 7,500 personnel exit the military from Camp Lejeune and New River Air Station, and whereas the economic impact of Camp Lejeune and New River Air Station comprise the largest single economic unit in Onslow County, and whereas the mayor and council publicly appreciate our active duty personnel, their families, veterans and veterans groups in our community. Now therefore, the mayor and the city council of the city of Jacksonville present the following. We commend active duty personnel, their family members, veterans and veterans groups for their continued work for the overall betterment of our military community. We continue to pledge our support to Camp Lejeune and New River Air Station and pledge to protect the training mission of the bases and encourage the military and all veterans groups to work together with NC Serves Coastal to ensure the veteran services are utilized and properly documented. It is my honor and privilege to present this proclamation tonight.
before we move on to our next presentation, I think it's very important to know how blessed we are to live in a community full of heroes. And if tonight's not a testament of who we are and who we represent in the city of Jacksonville, I'm not sure that I could ever live anyplace else. We are a home of heroes, and each and every one of you makes such an impact to our community and our military service members and their families and all of the needs that they have in each and every way. We couldn't do it without you. So on behalf of Mayor and Council, thank you so much for all that you do. One more presentation. I would like to ask Chief Mike Nero to please come forward, Sergeant Major retired Joe Houle, and Carmen Miracle to please come forward. As you all know, George Barrow, the past veteran liaison and good friend of the city, could not be with us tonight. But he has asked his friend, Reverend Jeff Andre, to please come forward to have a presentation. So, in 1989, Mr. Barrows received the Order of the Longleaf Pine. He received this honor after working with the Governor's Veterans Disabilities Advisory Board. Since then, he has submitted four names and nominations to the award, which were approved by the Governor and awarded. In recognition, Mr. Barrows purchased Society lapel pins and asked that they be presented tonight, so the honorees may wear them in recognition of the receipt of the state's highest award. So please help me in giving these guys a round of applause as we pass. Again, thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming tonight. I know many of you came out just for this event. We would like to take a 5-minute recess, so those of you who would like to go elsewhere, take your lovely bride out to supper, cut the grass, anything in that area, feel free to do so. So we'll be in recess for 5 minutes.
Buffalo. He's already gone there. She's going to join him, but that weather is kind of iffy, you know. So it's really not that far from Cleveland. Like 4 or 5. So, I saw your daughter's name in the paper the other day. She had a sign from some rascal, bad guy.
Yeah.
Well, of course. And I hope she does a good job. And they pay her well for it. You know. I remember Mac. Way back when, I guess he'd really done a really good job. And I guess the judge plays a role, or back then played a role on their reimbursement.
Yeah, it's more pretty much by schedule now.
Yeah, there was some discretion. He said he thought the judge thought he'd done a really good job.
Monitor went out.
Never gave him the grief he deserved for folding on this holiday.
I didn't fold.
Oh, you went with it?
I'd said earlier I would not favor creating a new holiday. The misinterpretation I realized later on was I was willing to substitute.
Oh.
I wasn't gonna add to another holiday.
Oh, I see.
And I've had a couple of people say, why did you vote to do away with Good Friday? I said, because I've worked the last 30 years and I've not had Good Friday as a holiday. It's never once affected my Christian faith. Not once. On the other hand, it means something important to him and perhaps other community members. I'm fine with it.
They're not fine. You'll say, I guess.
Floyd?
Tonight. No, we're getting blowback already.
Oh, are we? That's why we get big bucks.
Oh, it's fine. Man. All we gotta do is sit here. I'm saying. Bye, sweetie. Good to see you.
I haven't seen you.
I know, I know.
How have you been?
Doing good. Yes, I'm hard at it still. That's
oh, fine. Yeah. Just started the Marine Corps Reserve.
Oh, really? Okay.
So, always doing something.
That's Stan Walker over there.
But we have a law for abusing people.
Yeah, let's do it.
So who are we going to hear from?
No,
city employees?
No, the people they're not happy with the presentation. They're still not satisfied. I don't know. That's just what I heard. Yeah.
Did I butcher that up pretty good?
Fine. You were great. You were good. How's Sammy staying on here?
How are you?
Good to see you, sir.
Staying here.
Well, he's a politician.
Hey,
Carmen, hey.
My favorite friend.
Yes. Oh, yeah. I've used him. Yeah, I thought you were mad.
I ain't
got no politics.
That's right.
Thank you. Oh, Randy, you got a piece of string on you.
Oh, oh.
Good seeing you as always. Thank you,
yes,
sir.
Oh.
something maybe you said about giving up Good Friday, but
no.
Okay, if I could get everyone's attention, please, we're going to get back to our meeting. Okay. Okay, next order of business is the adoption of the minutes and agenda. You have before you the agenda and the minutes and consent agenda. If you can please review it and give me a motion.
Move adoption of the minutes and the consent items.
Have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Have a second. Any further discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Okay, now we are at our first section of public comment. We're only having one? Okay, so we're going to include it all in one. This time that the council has set aside for each speaker to hear comments from the public. This is not a question and answer session, but a time for you to express your views on city council issues. Each speaker who signed up to speak on the sheet may come to the podium when I call your name. Please state your name and address for the record. You may speak for up to 3 minutes when the timer at the podium and also displayed on the screen turns yellow. That means that you have 30 seconds of time remaining, so if you could please adhere to that, we would appreciate it. And I would like to ask Mr. Dwight Bletcher to come forward. Mr. Bletcher? Please state your name and address for the record.
Evening. Dwight Bletcher, 406 Spring Drive, Jacksonville, North Carolina, 28540. First, I want to thank the city of Jacksonville, the council. I understand our mayor, Sammy Phillips, can be here. I want to thank you for moving forward with the Veterans Proclamation that I had intended for. I thank you for this first phase. I think this is a right step or a correct step in the right direction. I still believe we have more work to do. I'm, you know, sad that the veterans couldn't stay actually a moment, but I'm very pleased with the city of Jacksonville. More importantly, I'm very pleased as a veteran. And I can assure all veterans and all citizens of Onslow County that with phase one, we will move into phase two. Eventually, we will not have any more deaths within our veteran community. Eventually, all veterans will get the rights and entitlements that they deserve. So again, I just want to thank you all for all the hard work and dedication that you did. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, next speaker I have is Dr. Amy Cicerone. Please come forward. Please state your name and address for the record.
Amy Cicerone, 107 Iverly Lane, Jacksonville, North Carolina. Mayor Phillips in absentia, members of Jacksonville City Council, county manager, and all assembled. I rise tonight to say thank you. Thank you for your vote to approve Freedom Day. We thank you for approving it as a holiday here in Jacksonville, especially in light of what took place this weekend at the National League of Cities in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, where the delegation voted overwhelmingly without challenge to adopt the resolution in support of the 13th Amendment. Hats off to you as a council for being first. We thank you for setting precedent in these United States, and you are to be commended. As a member and minister of the Freedom Church, the African Methodist Episcopal Zion Church, whose history and heritage is rooted in AME Zion preachers such as Sojourner Truth, Frederick Douglass, Harriet Tubman, and Bishop J.W. Hood, who helped to write North Carolina's first constitution, I am grateful. As we prepare to celebrate our first Freedom Day here in the city of Jacksonville, let us not forget both the past and the present atrocities that make the 13th Amendment or give it its power. Even as we consider the reason for it being written in the 1700s and 1800s regarding chattel slavery, and even today, the present day slavery of human trafficking, we ask that We will continue to support both the present and the past atrocities that have brought us to where we are. Thank you again for setting precedent, for being first, because now that the National League of Cities has it, it is looking forward to doing something to it or doing something with it on a national scale. But we were first, and we can stake that claim. Again, we ask that we not forget our past, because any people, be it a city, a family, or a race, who forgets its past, they will be bound to repeat it. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Next on the list, I have Marcia Wright. If you please come forward. Marcia, please state your name and address for the record.
I'm Marcia Wright, 2 West Bayshore Boulevard, Jacksonville, North Carolina, 28540. Thank you so much for letting me make a few comments. As the other speaker mentioned, I was hoping we would still have some veterans here because I came to speak about a new program that's here to serve that population. But as we all know, there is no higher calling than to dedicate one's life to the service of others. I am board chairperson for Eastern Carolina Human Services Agency, Incorporated, our local community action agency. We've been in operation for over 50 years, providing services to low-income families and working to help people out of poverty and into self-sufficiency. Our newest program is called NC Serves Coastal. It is a branch of America Serves, our nation's first coordinated network of public, private, nonprofit agencies working together to provide services to veterans and their families. Under this program, we will serve veterans in a 20-county area in eastern North Carolina by serving as a hub for resources and providers. The grant process for this project was very competitive, and we're really very proud to have been the recipient of this grant project. Many of us are or have been connected with the military, and we're very excited to partner with other agencies and organizations to better serve our veterans and their families. We also look forward to working with the City of Jacksonville, which has been very, very supportive of our agency over time, as well as Onslow County. The program manager for NC Serves Coastal is Mr. Jarek Vernon, a U.S. Air Force veteran, and he will be the face of this enterprise, and I'm sure that you will see more of him and his staff as we continue to work hard for our veterans and their families, as well as for people who are low-income citizens of eastern North Carolina. I'd like to take a moment to ask for any staff members we have from our program at Eastern Carolina, if they would stand just to be recognized. And we also have here Mrs. Daphne Hill, who is executive director of our program, if they would just stand to be acknowledged.
Thank you. Thank you for what you do.
So we will appreciate your support. We look forward to working with you, and we will be giving you more information as time goes by about how this program is going to operate, who we will serve, and the benefits and services that we can offer. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Marcia.
And we look forward to the partnership with USO.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Next speaker is Jared Vernon. Please come forward. Please state your name and address for the record, please.
Jared Vernon, 108 North Hill Court, Jacksonville, North Carolina, 28540. Just to piggyback off of what she said, I am here to recognize and just say thank you to our veterans. I am a U.S. Air Force veteran myself, and truly I've been advocating for veterans for the past few years with the SSVF program, and truly I'm just so happy to be able to continue to do that through the NC Serves Coastal program at Eastern Carolina Human Services Agency. We are coordinating a network of service providers serving veterans in 20 counties. If you seek to become a provider, please contact us. If you're a veteran and you're in need of services, please contact us at 1-844-435-1838. This is a big deal. It really is. I've seen it work. Just a few moments ago, in the crowd, I saw a provider that I had a gentleman call me crying because one of the providers that was in the audience, their agency provided the gentleman with like 100 gallons of gas. And that may not mean a lot to us, but that gentleman didn't have any heat, didn't have any air. I mean, he couldn't cook. And now he's able to do that, and I'm just so happy to be a part of that process. I see it work every day. So the more providers that we can encourage to become a part of the program, it's just going to be benefit all the veterans in this community and the other counties that we serve. Thank you for allowing me to address you, and just thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for your work. Okay, I have no one else signed up. Is there anyone else that wishes to speak that didn't get a chance to sign up? Okay, if no one else is here to speak, we'll close the public comment. Thank you all for being here. We have no further business. I guess we'll get to our reports, and we'll start at with Councilman Willingham.
Thank you, Mayor Pro Tem. Had the opportunity to attend the National League of Cities, and as Pastor Ciceron has indicated, the National League of Cities did adopt the resolution put forth by the City of Jacksonville. And so it was a very proud moment for me on behalf of the City of Jacksonville. And I have to show my appreciation for Councilmember Washington, because I truly believe that without her passion, without her efforts, that this would not have come to fruition on that level. She was a member of some critical committees. She moved the resolution through the committees, and it was well supported by the body at large. We also had an opportunity to make a presentation on behalf of the City of Jacksonville in the Small Cities, Big Ideas portion of the program. And the video, we used a lot of the video from the actual meeting and agenda item. And again, that was well received. And I have to thank the team. Glenn worked on it. Some of his staff worked on it. Our media folk, they did an outstanding job. I was a little nervous because my computer program wouldn't open it. But the presentation, I mean, the staff that was assisting us were able to play it. Everything worked perfectly, the slides, the video. So just much appreciation and respect to Team Jacksonville. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilman Bender?
No report.
Okay. I'll echo with what my council member said.
All right. Thank you. Councilman Thomas?
Okay, thank you. Just going to mention that I did attend the, was able to attend the groundbreaking ceremony for the addition on the county courthouse, and the city was mentioned as a partner in the exceptions that were required to get that project going. I just want to let you all know that that they appreciated our help with the project.
Thank you.
Just want to wish from my family to your family and to the audience and the folks at home a very merry and happy Thanksgiving. We do have so much to be grateful for, and God has blessed this country, and I'm truly grateful for that, and we need to continue so that he continues to bless us. So think about that when you say your prayers over your dinner and give thanks. So thank you.
Thank you. Dr. Woodruff? Go ahead, I'll finish it up.
We'd like to remind the public too much technical difficulty over here. Okay. So you don't push it, you just slide it? Is that what they taught you in law school?
Learned it along the way.
Okay. I'd like to remind the public that Thursday is Thanksgiving, and that means that Thursday and Friday are city holidays. If you have not yet placed your garbage containers out and you're normally collected on Thursday or Friday, you should do that this evening or early tomorrow morning. It'll be a long day for our personnel, but we will be collecting that garbage for those days. Secondly, we'd like to commend the city staff for the excellent work that they did on the Christmas holiday parade and also Veterans Day parade. As you're aware, other organizations put it on, but at the end of the day, it's our city. And it's your employees who are out there to clean the streets and make sure that they're returned to the standard that you have set. And I commend Kerry and his personnel for what they did after both of those parades. Also, we'd like to take just a moment to remind everyone that we live in a country that gives us the right to vote. Whether we liked the outcome of the presidential election or not, we will never forget that we still live in the greatest land of the free, and we had the right to cast a ballot. As your manager, I will tell you that my constant goal is to build this community. And I pledge to you and give you thanksgiving for the fact that you have set a standard that every city employee has embraced. The do it today, today not tomorrow attitude, is something that every employee in our city gives thanks for, because they appreciate the work that you and the taxpayers of this city provide. I wish each of you a very, very good Thanksgiving.
Thank you, Richard. John?
Just echo happy Thanksgiving to everyone.
Thank you. And I would like to echo a happy Thanksgiving to all of our staff and thank them for all the hard work that they do each and every day in service to our citizens. I would like to thank all of our viewers today and give them a happy Thanksgiving and hopefully safe travels. I would also like to thank Councilman Willingham and Councilwoman Angela Washington for their work at the NLC. I also attended, and it was well received. And your efforts are duly noted. So I would like to thank you for your efforts. And I wasn't able to attend the presentation, but I did hear a lot of great comments about it. So thank you again for all that you've done. And I would like to thank all of our veterans. And this is a special day for us each and every year that we do look forward to, because we don't thank them enough for what they do in our community and the service that they provide to all our service members and their families. So again, I want to thank everyone for being here tonight, and God bless all of you. Thank you. If I can have a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Meeting's adjourned. Thank you.